The spread of the coronavirus is having a broad impact on the economy throughout the world. And of course, that means right here at home as well. Tuesday, the Federal Reserve slashed interest rates by a half point.
And for some investors and anyone looking to refinance a loan, that could be a silver lining in this situation. Lakesha Williams is a financial advisor, and she is here to discuss how you can get started. Lakesha, welcome back. Glad to have you here.
I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
You know, these days, a lot of people could be really, really nervous about what's going on and obviously concerned. Should we, though, remain calm? What do you recommend these days?
Yes, definitely remain calm. Do not allow the short-term turbulence of the market to affect your long-term goals. Right. Because when you're dealing with your portfolio, that's long-term. If you're 60 years old, you know, you may have a little bit more of an impact. If you're 30, you're 40, you're 50, you have years to regain.
And even if you're 60, the way the market's been, you probably have some time to regain. But you, real estate is an option. If you do want to diversify a little bit, are you talking about real estate related stocks, or are you talking about actually, because interest rates are so low, maybe investing in hard physical real estate?
Real estate, in the market is an option. That's something that you have to talk to your financial advisor about specifically, because every case is a little bit different and depends on your goals.
Right.
But when you think about physical real estate, I want you to consider the acronym ARE, A-R-E.
A-R-E, okay.
Yes, whether you're acquiring real estate,
okay,
if you are refinancing your current real estate,
okay,
or if you're enhancing your first home or second home, I'm going to give you some tips,
okay,
that will impact you in this market in a positive way.
So tips like what, for example?
Okay. First, if you're acquiring real estate, this is a good time. If you thought about acquiring physical property for investment property, maybe even a second home, this is a perfect time to do that because the rates are at a historical low.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right.
So I spoke with my mortgage advisor on yesterday. Literally, you can acquire on a 30-year in the 2% range, 2.9%, 2.8%.
Are you serious?
On a purchase. And as low as on a refinance, sometimes the refinances are in the 3% range.
Wow.
So this is a good time to consider purchasing if that's something you've spoken with your financial advisor about,
okay,
and it's been on your radar.
And
especially in Memphis with the cost of living being so low,
right,
and our real estate is top in the country.
Yes, absolutely. And we're a great rental market. So
absolutely.
If you're investing for that purpose. Okay, the R, refinance.
Refinance. Now, this is something that I say you recommend if you are 4.5% or above.
Okay, because there are costs associated.
It's not free. Right. So just say if you're 4.5% or above, I would say call, go into your bank, preferably Regions, but go into your bank to see, okay, is this something that's advantageous for me?
Okay.
Now, if you're 4.5% and you're going maybe to 4%,
mm-hmm,
that may not be as advantageous if you only owe $50,000. But going from 4.5% to 4% or 3.5% could be quite advantageous for you financially if you have a larger loan amount,
okay,
because it reduces the interest significantly over the period of time.
What about the E?
The E, enhancement.
All right.
Now, many people have heard this acronym, and just hear me out. It's called a HELOC.
Mm-hmm.
It is not a wrestling move.
Wait, it's called a what?
It's a HELOC.
Okay.
It's not a wrestling move, not to be confused with a headlock. Totally different.
Thank you for clarifying.
Okay?
Thank you for clearing that up for us.
A HELOC is a home equity line of credit.
Okay.
And what this does, it uses the equity in your home to use for enhancements on your home. Just say if you wanted to put in a pool, or you say, hey, I've been in this house some time, I want to redo my kitchen.
That increases the value of the property.
That increases the value of the property. And the rates on the home equity lines of credit are really, really low now.
Mm.
And you can even use it. Typically, the home equity lines of credit are revolving.
Okay.
So you pay only on what you have outstanding, right?
Okay.
But once you finish it with the rates being so low, you have the option to lock that in,
mm,
and lock it in at a low rate so you know exactly what your payments will be ongoing.
Okay.
So this is a good option for people that's been in their home for a longer period of time and want to do some enhancements, put in that pool, redo the kitchen, redo the bathroom, maybe put in the hardwood floors, things like that.
Well, we have you here. What about looking at your assets? Should we reassess them? How often should we do that during times like these?
I would say meet with your financial advisor at least once a year. If you have a lot going, what we call life events, if you're getting married, you're getting divorced, you lost a parent, you lost a child, things like that, you may need to revisit more often because you have so much going on, but at the minimum once a year. And then sometimes you say, hey, I know I'm going to retire in the next 5 years. That may be a good time to get with your financial advisor and maybe kind of start steering towards more conservative investments. So if we do have a down market, you don't take as much of a hit. But again, that's something to talk about 101 with your advisor.
All right, thank you so much. Some great ideas.
Thank you, my pleasure.
Good to have you here.
It's my pleasure. See you again.
And what's that move called again?
The HELOC, not the headlock.
All right.
With you in our corner, we will survive.
You will survive.
We're ready for anything.
I can throw you to the mat, and you'll be fine.